Hello, my name is Zico Kersik. I'm the Assistant Vice President for Facilities, Planning, and Operations here at Queens College. Since the spring of 2020, my facilities teams and I have been working constantly to ensure that our facilities remain safe for our essential workers and anyone else accessing the campus. Now, as we begin to offer more in-person classes this fall and spring semester, we are proceeding with the understanding that good air quality, as maintained through enhanced ventilation, is the key to a healthy work and study environment. Our facilities teams have been and will continue working on enhancements to our heating, cooling, and ventilation systems. Our building ventilation system has been adjusted to ensure maximum fresh air while maintaining stable interior environments. We have also adjusted our automatic controls for the HVAC equipment to ensure maximum air turnover. HVAC filters have been upgraded to those of higher ratings such as MERV 13, while our teams continue to ensure that all of our systems are monitored for proper operation. During the winter, safe temperature will be maintained while we continuously ensure that fresh air is being added and recirculated. During the summer, our buildings will be cooled while controlling for humidity as best possible and ensuring proper ventilation. Routine inspections will ensure that all our operable windows are functioning properly and that the same is true for the exhaust fans in our elevators as well as the restrooms. Our facilities teams will continue to deploy enhancements to air quality throughout the interior of our campus buildings. We are deploying ultraviolet or UV technology as well as HEPA technology. Maximum permitted occupancy for our interior spaces will continue to be revised per COVID-19 guidelines. Additionally, we have invested in surface disinfection materials, which we installed on hard-touch surfaces such as door handles and elevator buttons. Should you encounter any facility-related issues, please report them promptly to Office of Buildings and Grounds. Let me assure you that our facilities teams will continue to ensure a safe campus environment, so that all of you may focus on teaching and learning. Please remember that ultimately, success of our safety plan depends on each one of us as members of our campus community. We all must follow and adhere to all the guidelines of our overall safety plan. We thank you